Hello, my divine kings and queens. I'm back to do another video. In today's message, what I'm going to be going over is God is saying, because they sold you out, you bought the show out. Yeah. God say, because they sold you out, you bought the show out. And what I mean by that is, a lot of you guys had a lot of Judases, but you also had a lot of Peters in your life. And what I mean by that, not only did you have people who were plotting behind your back, people who were mocking you, people who was betraying you, people who did not want or did not have your best interests at heart. They did not want to see you prosper or succeed. You also had people of whom you helped, people of whom you stood and went to bat for, people of whom you would have fought and gave your last to, turned around. And when the heat and when it what it say, if you can't take the heat, get out the kitchen. When it got hot, everybody just ran and left you there. No one was like, no, I know so and so, like you're not about to do that. No, I got so and so back. No, I can vouch for so and so, they don't do that. So stop lying on their name, stop doing this. I know them, you just hating. You had a whole lot of people that were not trying to defend you. You had a lot of people who at the end of the day, instead of trying to be there for you like you were to them, they just act like they ain't know you. I mean, roped you off completely. Like if someone was to ask them, do you know this person? You cool with this person? See, to your face, they acted like they was cool with you, but behind your back, they was telling people it was everything but. Like some of this stuff, you know, it'll hurt you if you knew how people really viewed you. And see, this is why I tell y'all, a part of being chosen, some of it you feel like it's a curse because you feel like you see other people getting in relationships or getting in friendships and things like that. And see, you don't even understand why you're going through what you're going through as far as why this stuff don't come so easily to you as it would someone else. And see, what it is you was in spiritual boot camp. And God had picked you at a very young age to start this. And this is why you're so spiritually advanced than most folk. This is why the energy ain't there and the mindset ain't there with a whole lot of people that you was trying to connect with. This is why it did not work. Instead of looking at what God has blessed you with as a curse, look at it as for what it is. It's a blessing because you can smell BS a mile away, as opposed to some people. They can't smell it, or if they do, they so dependent on needing people in their life. But see, we done went through the trenches, so we ain't about all that. We like, listen, we know what that feel like. I don't want to feel that way no more. You're spiritually advanced than a whole lot of people that's probably older than you or younger than you, because you started and God recruited you to be a part of this spiritual boot camp at a very young age. So a lot of things that you went through at a young age, I'm talking about betrayals through friendships, seeing things about your family, going through things just in all aspects of your life. He was training you, molding you, reshaping you, right? Tearing you down to put you back up again. And what I mean by tearing you down, just breaking down piece by piece of who you were. You didn't know who you were all, like, in the beginning, you didn't know who you were. So he gave you bits and pieces of who you were as you went along and you passed these different phases, right? Doors that God was closing, you kept opening. This is why it delayed your progression. It delayed, you could have, your graduation. It delayed your graduation date, right? So your graduation date would have been sooner than what it was, but you were opening up doors that should have been closed. And this is why I say when God deliver you from a thing, you don't go back to it. You don't go back to that thing or to those people, to those situations of what he delivered you from, because you may not make it out the next time that you go back. And see, these are things that you had to learn. You had to learn it. So as you, some of y'all may be like, you know, I lost years out on my childhood. I wish I could get those years back. I wish I could have just had fun. Let me tell you something. Work hard now so you could play later. That's what God was trying to show you. You didn't understand it. A whole lot of them people who was playing back then, they trying to work hard now. God had you working all, you've been working all your life. All my life I had to work. All your life, you had to work and you had to fight. Huh? You was going up against spiritual demons. You was going up against spiritual attacks, spiritual warfare, baby, that you didn't even know. And see, the thing is, you was just pouncing it off of you like it was nothing. Huh? Because of God, how God prepared you. He said this was preparation for your elevation. You get me what I'm saying? This is why you had to go through that spiritual boot camp at a young age. This is why where you are right now, completely different than where you were back then. And this is why God is so proud of you. Like, man, you surprised me. You just passing this thing like this. You just beyond me. Oh, you acting totally different, huh? Because you done learned them lessons. This is why you can't. A lot of people didn't start. See, look at that as a blessing that man picked you and recruited you at a young age. Huh? You got a lot of people who at this stage of their life, they trying to get to where you are. You got years up on these people. The type of experience that you got over these people, man, they can't even think. They won't be able to go through what you went through. This is the thing. This is why I say, God is looking at you, telling you stop looking at it as a curse. Look at it as a blessing, because he's saving you from getting into a lot of toxic situationships. That one that you went through just set it. It set that standard. Like, I'm not going through that. I'm not going through that. I'm not dealing with that. I don't have to. Can't nobody make me. You just different. You're not going to mesh and get with a whole lot of people who, like I said, a whole lot of people didn't start young. They just now starting. They not where you are. So that's why it don't connect. But like I said, on this journey, it prepared you. It strengthened your mind. You know, it helps you see things from a different perspective of how you really need to be walking, talking, and moving out here. See, the thing is, these people, when they went up against you, they didn't know who they was going up against. And see, the reason why God shielded you and protected you, so a whole lot of people wouldn't see, because he was trying to see how these people would treat you and how they would deal with you. See, it was lessons on both ends. Lessons on your end. God like, listen, I'm about to kill two birds with one stone. You about to learn a lesson on how you shouldn't be allowing people to treat you. And they about to learn a lesson about who they don't need to be treating any kind of way. Not knowing who people really are. And even if they knew who you were, like I said, God needed to know, man, whether you knew who this person was or not. What you showed me is your mannerisms and your characteristic and who you truly are as a person. It don't matter about how a person treats you when they know you ain't nobody to be played around with. It ain't about how a person treats you when they know that you spiritually protected or that you grounded. It ain't about how a person treats you when you up on top and they know that you're going to get it or they know that you're going to be here at a certain stage in your life. It's about how a person treats you when they don't know these things. Because, see, that's a person who's going to treat you whether for the good or for the bad. For the ups, for the downs, for the highs, for the lows. Those are people that's crossed all levels. Everybody gonna get the same treatment because that's they insides is right. You get me what I'm saying? You had to learn, and these people had to learn. And God said, because they sold you out, you about to show out. They sold you out, and hold on. And when they did it, they mind was made up. These people was aware of what they was doing. They was aware. They were aware, sweetheart. Yes, they were. Yes, they were. Don't get it twisted. Huh? The only reason why these people trying to come back with that act right, the only reason why people looking at you in a different light is because of how God got you through and how he blessed you and the things that they know that you about to do. They sold you out. And when they did it, they mind was made up. And when they went to where they went to and it blew up in their face, they turned around and they saw how God raised you up. I'm telling you, it's like these people was dragging your name up and down, up and down, down and up, to and fro, all around, up and down, went and got some dog poo, went and gathered some feces, all kind of stuff, and went and took it and dragged it up and down some more, stepped on it, spit on it, cut it up, put it back together so they could up and down some more, up and down the stream, and they didn't have no intentions to stop until God brought them down to their knees. And let me tell you how he did that. Let me tell you how they did that. The gag is what these people were searching for. All that what they was talking about. Everything that transpired. It didn't go in these people's favor. It went in your favor. Because see, even when it was bad, it was good. Because you learned lessons out of that. It built you. You got stronger out of that. You got wiser out of that. And now you know nonsense now that God brought bringing these blessings in. So even when it was bad, it was good. And when it was good, oh yeah, it was real good. Not complaining, not wanting, not needing for anything. And they had to sit and watch it. A lot of these people knew what was being done to you and chose to fall on deaf ear and a blind eye. This is why you get in your new beginning, and this is why God is dealing with these people individually. Because let me tell you something, you don't do that. It's lessons to be learned across all levels. I'm telling you, you had Judases and you had Peters in your life, people who was really seeking out to harm you, had no real reason, legitimate reason, right? Like, I'm trying to tell you something. If they had to go and it was in court, and God had to go down to this and say, state your case. Why did you do this towards this person? They don't went, can't afford a real lawyer, and got a public defender. The public defender don't even know how to defend these people because he don't know the reason. Ain't no motive. You're like, how I'm gonna win this case? What did you do this for? That's just what I was feeling. I just didn't like them. I don't know why I don't like them. I just didn't like them. That's why I need you to defend me and get me off. The public defender don't even want to defend these people. Like, you went against somebody you ain't got no real reason, but you want me to get you off because now you on trial. You on trial for your life. You don't want to put this person through all this strife. And you want me to sit up here and make it right. And you don't even know why you did it. Yeah. Pretty much. That sums it up. I say, nah, you really about to feel it. You know what I'm saying? For the people who didn't want to say nothing. And for the people who went out here and really was plotting and scheming on your downfall. They sold you out to the highest bidder. Sold you out thinking with they heavy hitter. Sold you out and God done bless you and now they bitter. But let me tell you something. That ain't your fault. God said they sold you out. And now you about to show out. Don't you play. And don't listen. Don't misconstrue my words and get this twisted. You don't go back to the thing of which God delivered you from. Because these people showed you who they are. They showed you who they are. They showed you that they didn't have your best interest. They showed you that they didn't like you. They showed you that they wasn't meant for you and they didn't need to be in your life. Thank God that he got these snakes out your circle. Let me tell you something. It wasn't easy at first to get them snakes out your circle because they shed their skin so many times you couldn't tell the forest from the trees. They slithering and shedding again and still, no, I do love you. I do. I just got to find a way of showing it. I just sometimes like talking your business behind your back. I sometimes, you know, get jealous at you because, like, I don't understand how you do what you do and the things that you done been through and how you make it out. I mean, you don't give me no reason because you always beat up for me. You don't be judging me. But, you know, I love you. I just got a funny way of showing it. That's all. I love you. I'm your friend. On one, the one that you can depend. Sometimes I like talking about you to other friends. That's all. I mean, but I'm your friend. Like, it don't change nothing. I'm your friend, you know? Yeah, I'm your family, girl. Blood thicker than water. We all we got. Sometimes I just, you know, we judge you because we didn't understand why you did what you did. We talked about it amongst ourselves. I mean, it was kind of funny to a certain extent, though, because, you know, we felt like you should have known better. You know, as if because we so perfect, we don't do no wrong and we know everything and we don't make no mistakes and all our relationships be golden and, you know, everything just always be on the up and up for us. So we just felt like we could judge you and laugh at you. But, you know, we your family. Sometimes we love you. We just be having a funny way of showing it. That's all. I say snakety snake. And they need to get cut indefinitely. They sold you out. Ain't no taking that back. Ain't no reneging. It ain't no what. Can we put it back together? Did you think of that before you went on ahead and sold somebody out? I don't think they did. And God said, because they sold you out. They sold you out. They talked about you. They did not think that you was going to make it through. They didn't count on the favor over your life. They didn't count of how much God loved you. They didn't count on the plan that God had for you to bring you through the whole time. They didn't count on it. Because they was too busy trying to count you out. Too busy trying to rope you off. Too busy trying to plot and scheme behind the scenes. Because they too cowardly to come out from that cloak and tell you, I don't vibe with you. I don't like you. I ain't got a reason, but I just don't. Let me tell you something. Now God say, you don't have to have a reason, but let me tell you something. You're going to get up off of this one. You can bet your life on that. You're going to get up off of this one. Because ain't nothing that these people doing is touching you. But yet they keep trying to go back to the drawing board and trying to figure out how to scheme. How to take from you. How to manipulate you. How to play you. When all people got to do is be real. And then they can't come with that real. They know we ain't accepting the fake. They sold you out. But God gave you purpose. He always knew that this was going to happen. You didn't understand the master plan. But see, let me tell you something. Now it's all making sense to you. It's all making sense to you on how God was going to bring you through and how God had this set up. You knew me before I was a little girl you gave. You gave me purpose. You wrote my life. But as I got older, it became harder to deal. 'Cause people I thought loved me, they wasn't real. They took me for granted. Broke my very heart. I came in with love, but they was plotting from the start. They knew they didn't mean me well, but faked it to the end. I thought that I was left for dead until you swooped on in. Love of my life, you are my friend. Love of my life, for you I can't depend. Yeah. I feel so good inside. Feels like I started a new life again. Love of my life. God, you know that I'm not perfect, but you still saw the good and you bless me. Oh, that man still blessed you. He see the good when people try to keep throwing the bad. He knew how he was going to bless you when people kept trying to block you. He knew how he was going to rise you up when people kept trying to knock you down. He was trying to get you to see. And it was so hard because you had all these Judases and Peters surrounded around you. But that man fought. He fought like crazy. And he didn't give up on you because he saw, he knew you was not going to make it through that. You had too many people trying to attack you and come up against you. One little you. They had to formulate groups of 10, 20, 50. That should show you something. For one person, you got to keep going back to the drawing board, calling on who you need to call on to see what else you need to do. What can you do to stop the person? What can you do to get this and get that? When all people had to do was when they had you, be real with you. When people had you, they should have did right by you. And now people is getting sat down like it ain't nobody business. God wrote out your life and he gave you purpose. You didn't understand it because you was going through spiritual boot camp. And you had to learn what was going through these spiritual sessions that made you spiritually equipped to handle, to fight back, and to stand up to these demonic, relentless devils. I'm trying to tell you something. They sold you out and they ain't think twice about it, baby. So don't you think twice about what you about to do with all this blessings and peace that is coming your way. If you say, you know what? It's time I think about me. Since everybody was thinking about themselves, you do just that. God ain't going to condemn you and he ain't going to look at you no different in any kind of way. Because he know what you was faced and what you was going up against in these people. These people did not know, but he knew and opened up your eyes so you could see. Stop playing with me, man. Wake up and pay attention and know what this really is. Stop getting mad when a person want to back up from you and don't want to deal with you. Be like, hey, partner, you know, that's what you want to do. That's what you want to do. When a person go up against you, you can't control how people think and how they going to move. What you can control is how you react to it, your reaction, and how you move and treat these people moving forward. You treat them accordingly. You categorize them accordingly based on how they treated you, not based on how they're trying to come back. Based on how a person initially treats you is how they are. I can't think twice on what I've done when I've met a person. Like when I initially meet a person, I'm good to them. Why would I come in with ill intent and I don't even know this person? And you know what movie I was watching the other day? It's one of my favorite movies, and don't judge me because I tell y'all this is a judgment-free zone channel. Cruel Intentions. And I don't know, for whatever the reason, this movie was just pressing on me. Like, I was like, oh, I gotta watch this. And there was a line that stuck out. That whole movie, you know, it was messages in that movie. But one thing that the Stuck brother said, Ryan Phillippe or whatever his name is, he said to Sarah Geller, Michelle, whatever her name is, and that his sister, he was like, I want you to understand, we're about to ruin an innocent girl, an innocent person. And she was just so caught up on getting revenge, like, and getting it through this person that she didn't even know, that hadn't even done anything directly to harm her. You know what I'm saying? And she was like, yeah, I know what we about to do. I know what we about to do. I don't care. I still want to go through with it. And mind you, he was okay with it, right? But that's not who he really wanted. The person he was going up against, he didn't really want that person. He wanted the other girl, right? And she found a way to mess that up. She was a very hateful, bitter, vengeful, just evil person. And these are the type of people that she was dealing with in your life. You had several of them in your life. One minute they want to go against you, and then when they see that you overcome and that you happy, they try to crap on your happiness and crap on your peace and your success because they don't want you to have it. Because they know that everything that they did, it's like a direct reflection to them. It's a direct reflection on them and who they are. Even people who don't know you and don't really vibe with you like that is seeing how people went up against you and saw how you handle it. And it's like these people don't even want to deal. That everybody is going up against everybody right now. Them same groups that was formulated is breaking up. Because people don't understand it. At this point, people don't understand it. At one point in time, they did, right? One point in time, they was on board with it. Then they like, okay, well, dang, I mean, this ain't paying our bills and we taking time out of our day to try to go up against somebody, plot, fake, and be up in their face and do all this so that they be confused. Like, I mean, what's wrong with you? Is you mental or something? Like, I'm trying to figure it out. Nobody could figure it out. And eventually, what happened in the end? She was exposed for the trifling person and two-timing and deceitful person that she is. Now, what it do for her? I don't know what it's going to do for her in her future. Hopefully, it changed her character. Hopefully, she changed and she learned from that and she healed. Whatever it is broken up in her. But it caused division in places that it didn't need to cause division. It caused confusion, delays, and hurt and heartbreak when it didn't need to happen. But these are the type of people that you was dealing with. You was dealing with some real vengeful, relentless people. Some that you had no direct correlation to. You get me what I'm saying? It was through somebody that this twice removed and this, that, oh, I don't like you. Don't even directly know you. Don't take the time out to figure out who you are. Just, I'm coming in with ill intent. I'm coming in trying to hurt you. I'm coming in trying to get back at you. You ain't do nothing to me. You don't even know that I'm doing it behind your back. But I ain't going to stop and I ain't going to cease until I see you down. And God say, listen, you ain't going to stop. You ain't going to cease. You ain't going to stop. You ain't going to cease. What you doing, it ain't working anyway. But you ain't going to stop and you ain't going to cease. Yeah, I'm going to see about that. I'm telling you, it's like these people was dragging you up and down, down and up and down, to and fro, all around. And they wasn't trying to stop until God to bring them down to their knees. And he still got a couple more that he got to go down the list on and check when it come to you. You going to be the example. I'm telling you, you ain't going to understand why that man chose you. He was building you. He knew what he was setting you and preparing you for. To take the stand, to step up in this position that he created specially for you. Only you could have carried it out like this. He needed someone just like you to understand how to handle it, how to get through it. You were going to listen. You was going to be obedient as unto him. You had learned the lessons that you needed to learn. These people didn't understand that. You were already advanced before these people started attacking you. The only reason why God allowed some of this stuff to work is so you would see who these people are. Sometimes a way in exposing is allowing, touching you so you would see, okay, now you see who you got in this person. Now you see they was never your friend. I didn't tell you that they was your friend to start off with. You chased that, but now you see. Now you see who your family really is. It's going to be hard, you know, but till people get their mind right and get their soul right and heal where they need to heal, they going to always hate you and they ain't going to never recognize you for the gem that you are. So back up and get on, because you the one who I chose anyway to break these curses and to step into this generational wealth. So what you care? Just pray for people and step back and let them heal on their own. Sometimes you got to love people from a distance. Sometimes people got to lose you in order to know what they had and to begin with. Sometimes you got to lose in order to win again. God had to expose these people to you so you would see. It wasn't to hurt you, baby. It was to open up your eyes so you get them out your life and keep them up out your life. And it's a huge lesson to these people. I think you're going to think next time before you try to pick somebody of whom you want to go up against for reasons that you can't even justify. Because you don't have any reasons. Heal. Because that's the only reason where this jealousy and envy and evilness is coming from. Some people are so grounded and rooted in that. They don't know no other way to be. And what I tell you, when you come across people like that, you got to sit back and you got to let God handle them. That's what I'm saying. Y'all was trying to play savior. Trying to save people when you want to be saved, man. They were trying to destroy you. You kept trying to save them. These are people who were supposed to be on your path to teach you a lesson. Not trying to love them. Not you trying to drag out the lesson. That's what y'all was doing. Y'all was dragging out the lesson. God trying to close that chapter. You like, no, I got to write some more to the chapter. I say, ain't no more to write. I wrote this. This chapter is supposed to end here. So end it. And if you can't end it, I'm going to step in and I'm going to end it. And it ain't going to be pretty. And sometimes, for some of y'all, y'all didn't go through no pretty situations. But it taught you and it woke you up. So stop looking at it as a curse that you was chosen. And look at it as a blessing. Because some people wish they were in your shoes to understand and think and move the way that you do. They can't. They ain't got the courage. They ain't got the will. It takes will to be celibate and remain that way until the right person come along. It takes will to not want to screw someone over, even though the opportunity presents itself to you. A lot of people, these people use around, the opportunity presented itself for them to betray you, for them to go after what was once yours, for them to talk about you, and they took it. They didn't think about what it was going to do to you. They didn't think about if that got back to you, how that was going to hurt you. They didn't think about it at that time when they was talking and blabbering and motor mouths. They didn't think about how it was going to tarnish their reputation and your perception of these people. They didn't think about it. They didn't think about it. They didn't think like, man, you know, so-and-so ain't going to look at me the same no more, man. I'll never be able to, so-and-so will never be my friend again. No, they did it. They did it. They didn't think. They did it. They was like, it's fair game. They sold you out. And God said, because they sold you out. They sold you out. And when they did it, their mind was made up. Their mind was made up when they did that. They only turned around because where they went to trying to keep finding the greener pastures and the greener grass, where they went to thinking that it was going to work for them and they was going to be able to throw something up in your face, where they went to thinking that, oh, you was never going to be nothing in life and they was going to always be at the top, you was going to be at the bottom and they was going to feel superior, where they thought you would be, you didn't end up. And where they thought that they were going to be, they didn't end up. God rerouted this whole thing and he stepped in right smack in the middle. And he said, I gave you a chance to rectify this. I gave you a chance. I gave every single last one of y'all chances to right your wrongs. And I saw how y'all relished in that, how y'all, you was proud of what you had done. You was happy. Joyous that you was suffering and they thought they had did something to you. They was happy that you was suffering. He got smacked down there in the middle. And where they thought they was be, where they thought they would be, God say, no, reroute it. This where you about to be. And where they thought that you was going to stay and how they thought you was going to end up, God went and took that and gave that outcome to these people. Because you don't do that. God say, because they sold you out, baby, you about to show out. It's your season. It's your time to rise. Think about yourself. And put yourself first this time. But I don't have to tell you that. I think based on the series of events that you've gone through, you should know that by now. To put yourself first. To love yourself better. And always continue to heal. And do right by others. Do unto others as you have done to yourself. And until next time, stay prayed up and be blessed. I love y'all.